My name is Sarah Hansen. I've been teaching the General Chemistry Lab since 2004. This course is a completely independent course, separate from the lecture course in General Chemistry, which means we have students at all different places in the General Chemistry lecture sequence. We have a number of post-bacs, we have engineering students, we have undergrads from really the entire Columbia community taking this course, and that's one of the things I love about it. During lecture, we noticed some students were frantically writing notes and really overwhelmed. Other students were familiar with a lot of the content and either checked out or just knew the material and needed to be challenged some more. Before students arrive, they're asked to watch some videos, and sometimes there's a web page with additional content to read over, sometimes a simulation, but usually it's videos. They also have a pre-class quiz that takes most students about 2 minutes and allows them to assess their own learning. Once they come to class, we usually start out with a little bit of a poll to see where students are at, what they're wondering about, what they're asking for more content on. And we've started incorporating large sections of time where they are problem solving. So sometimes it's back and forth, a few minutes to think, then they answer a question. But more and more we're shifting towards maybe 20 minutes of individual and group problem solving. I have access to the pre-class quiz. So any students that take the pre-class quiz, I can actually see where those students are and what they need out of the lecture. I like to frame the lecture as somewhat of a choose-your-own-adventure because based on their answers, I'm going to tailor the, I have a little bit of the class structured, but then the rest of it is based on what they need to talk about at that time. The idea is that they leave with targeted things they need to study. Now they say, okay, I understood this material, I didn't understand this material, and here are some problems that I want to revisit on the discussion board or in office hours. CTL has really provided support in ideas. That's been the biggest thing. I had some problems and I had a few ideas, but I wasn't really sure how to implement them. And CTL has provided support for developing the ideas on how to use the polling, best practices for active learning in the classroom, how to train the TAs in active learning, and how to look at the assessment data I was getting from the course.